was a spiteful wrench. Wow, look at the damage. 74 at level 1, but it requires level 5 to use it. You may think here's level 4? Probably just 3 and 5s. Eh, it was worth a shot. I guess the good news is, with restarting the world, it looks like it does refresh all the items. Yeah, Wayne. You believe that, Wayne. Somebody help me with this bloody door. Remember me, mate. I'm the doctor, but I can't do much without medical supplies. The door to the infirmary is locked from the other side, and Anne's in critical condition. You think you can help me break the bloody thing down? Let's see. This is easy. You get 500 XP and cash. What do we gotta do? There's a zombie in there. Painkillers. Bandages. Magnet. Doc, it's a, hold on, Doc. We can't have it quite yet. I'm gonna take this cash first. Alright, Doc, now you can have it. All right, Doc, all yours. Of course, you have another quest for me. What is it, drag the bodies out for you? Nothing here at all, is there? You can think of another way. Will you help me? It's one of the lifeguard vehicles. Inside, you'll find a paramedic bag with all the necessary equipment. Pretty sure I saw one by the diamond bunkhouse. This is a medium with 700 XP and a sickle. You can count on it. We'll do it later. But we'll take it. Bloody walking corpses. My dogfish head alcohol says whatever. It says drink me, actually. Kelly's worried about her husband, Will. But I think he's probably okay. If you happen to be nearby there, you see if you can find him. Nearby where? Oh, a concierge named William.
Absolutely.
His name is William. He's about 6'1", black hair, good looking. He's a concierge. He has a friend named Doyle who works in the Diamond District bungalows. I'm thinking maybe he's hiding out there.
I ran out in such a rush of the time. It's in bungalow 6 in the silver section. My husband gave it to me. It means a lot to me. I'm offering a reward. Can you help me?
Easy?
Sure.
Thank you. Please, be careful.
We're gonna explore, 'cause that's what we do. We explore everything.
Get some gas from that station.
very hard.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Sure, we'll do it later. We'll take it, but we'll do it later. And that looks like it is it. Now let's explore our new safe zone. It's so safe that the door opened up. Automatic door. Automatic partial door. Great, I broke the door. Guys, this is no longer a safe zone. Never mind, I fixed the door. And you can always head back the way you were. Okay, that's cool. Alright, but it keeps bitching I have points. Well, I say we take your points and we start looking at combat here. Blunt weapons are now more efficient. They do more damage. They cost less stamina. They get a better crit chance. And they do better head damage. I never found a way to see how much space I had, though. Which is slightly annoying, because it doesn't tell you. Alright, well, let's take a look. Quests, what do we got? We got a bunch here. Oh, can I finally do the Maggie quest? No. I get so happy and so excited thinking I can go find Maggie. Then I'm quickly abused of that decision.
No. All right,
medium, very easy, medium, medium. Alright, let's try to get the car up and running. It says it's an easy quest. It says actually it's a very easy quest. Therefore, we will do it. We're looking for cars that we can steal car parts from. Seems pretty basic. What is that map showing down the road? Oh, it shows the first car part. Just directly ahead of me. I don't like that coughing from the inside of that. It's kind of disarming and not really scary, but makes you go, okay, what has she got that's going to spread now? Because, well, this is a zombie game, and that's what happens in zombie games. People get sick, and it spreads from person to person quickly. She has gears on her, and he has glue on him. That makes a lot of sense. Good news is, we've already got three of our four parts. Alright. Come on, boy. Batter's up! Okay, that was actually really cool. Messing with me, try to run at me, I knock your head off with one swing. Let's pop one of these bad boys as we go. Alright, 27 meters to the next and final. Oh boy. Come here, thuggy boy. Come on. Gonna send your girlfriend in first? Alright, Suzuki. Okay, that's right. Go for the arm and then knock him off. That's right, that's right, that's right. My fault. Take this. Now, does he get back his health or his arms? No. What I'd like is a gun. But we don't get a gun. We get a worthless little crowbar. That should be our last car part, so now we can get the heck out of here, go get the car up and running. Our football player, man, he can definitely make it. He definitely got some legs on him. That wasn't very polite there, sir. Alright, who is coughing? Because I'm going to have to kill you. Alright. I'll let you be. I see who's coughing. It's actually the quest target. That's fine, because there were some energy drinks back here. All is not for naught. Like you do, dude. How would you react in a zombie outbreak? You'd probably curl up and start crying because you didn't know what to do. At least that man took charge and... Oh, that's cool. You can buy drinks for $5. Cool. Where's the repair thing out here again? Another energy drink or two out here. Another energy drink there. Wow. I mean, that's just going to take a boatload of money to keep up and running. I can tell you that right now. Although it did look like, you know, the guy back there had some better tools. So once we get to level 5, we'll be able to update our tools and get with him. Take a look at this map. Where is this bungalow at? Find a paramedic. Kim. There's two quests up there. And there's the bungalow thing. We were almost already up there. And there's two quests up there, too. So, we gotta wait for this guy to fix the truck. So he said he needed a few minutes.